EDL certified inside documentary, right? So man's turned up to Coventry, yeah, on a random one, with no P. But it's the EDL of art. So, man strapped the camera. He's gonna go see what I'm on with this thing.
I welcome that. Anybody that wants to be something on Saturday and say for most of that, then applause that. Whatever group that is, whether that be a more radicalized form of society, such as some of the Baptist Church, they are as here as I'm just showing you. They should be part of the church.
To express whatever they like, you know.
Able to break the habits that break us a prisoner. He's able to heal the broken hearted. He's able to set the prisoners free. He's able to save the very
utmost. Sorry, darling, can I film that?
You sure? Yes.
I'd seen before, like,
sorry, the money. That's the culture of the ruling class in this country. So defend your culture. But behind the facade of the EDL, they have one purpose in mind. And that is to turn worker against worker. To turn worker against worker on the basis of skin colour, on the basis of religion, on the basis of ethnicity, whatever excuse that they can find. No, we know now we're in an economic crisis. Coventry today is not what it was in the period of the 1980s. We know that. But with crisis that we are in, we did not cause. We didn't impose the austerity. We didn't make the banks fail. Yet we as workers, of all colours, of all creeds, of all ethnicities, we are the ones who are paying the price. So we have to fight back. We have to fight as a united working class, as a united trade union movement, to defend the gains that we made in the past. We have to fight back to enhance our standards of living. And we have to fight to change the nature of the society in which we live. We can only do that as a united labour and trade union movement, as a united working class. That's why I'm here today to oppose the EDL. Because that's an organisation which will use every means at its disposal to crush us as a united movement. Thank you, sisters and brothers. Woo! Now is the time, now is the time.
Okay. How's that? Is that better?
Yeah.
Our golden voice, you see. Alright then. Yes, my name's Chris. I'm a Coventry student here. I'm a member of Youth Party for Jobs and a member of Socialist Party here. I have to say, I've only been here for 3 years, but I am taking immense pride in seeing all these different workers, all these different people from different walks of life. I'm taking immense pride looking at all you now, all these different people who came from different walks of life, different workers, different nationalities, all come together in one common goal, which is to expose the lies of the EDL, to expose their racist rhetoric, and to drive their simple lies out of this town. I have to say, I'm preaching to the choir when I say how important it is when we all come together and get mobilised to actually cut across all the lies they're putting out. But it's not just a fact to defeat them on one day. Don't get me wrong, it's good when racism gets challenged on a daily basis. But I got told once by a friend that when it comes to racism, it's always good to think about rotten fruit. And when I say that, it's because, say you pick up an orange, has a bit of mould on it. Just because you take off the mould doesn't mean it's good to eat. All that harmful and disgusting bacteria underneath is still there. And that's just like racism. Just because you do one protest, which is needed, that doesn't get rid of racism in society. You have to get rid of all the contributing reasons that allow racism in the first place to grow. That's lack of housing, that's unemployment, that's your services being cut, that's your neighbours, your family, your friends having to rely on food banks even though they're still working half the time on ZR contracts on minimum wage. So if we truly want to defeat racism, we have to fight the symptoms but also fight the causes. And the way to fight the causes is to provide all those things I said, to provide housing for everyone, to provide proper jobs, to get a living wage out there, and get all that wealth and resources that workers like me and you generate in this society that's being ordered away by a tiny portion of society who hide their money away in offshore banks, or as we know now in Panama, a lot of places that we haven't been to. We redistribute that to get all those things. But we can't do that under this system right now. This system, under this Tory government, under Cameron, under capitalism, we are not going to get those things, because at the end of the day, this system does one thing and one thing only. It puts profits first, not people. And that allows the far right, like the EDL, to try and capitalise that. Because at the end of the day, we can all understand why there's an anger in society. We can understand why people are being disenfranchised, why people are being disillusioned, why people who are on housing lists that go on for years, that are working on slave labour kind of workshop kind of things. We can understand why that anger is there, but we can't allow them to divide workers against each other. It's already been mentioned. Because at the end of the day, racism only does the work, the dirty work of the establishment. It pits us against each other. So if you want to challenge racism, we have to challenge capitalism. And like Malcolm X once said, can't have capitalism without racism. So let's fight racism today, let's also fight for socialism, let's fight for an alternative that can provide all the stuff we need to stamp out racism and have the life that we all deserve and the life that we want the next generation to have. Thank you very much.
Alright, try and speak loudly so everyone can hear it. It's called "You Don't Put Your Baby on a Boat That Might Sink." A mother's love is stronger than any other bond. A mother would die to give her child a chance to hold on. This mother looks very different from mine. Tan skin, dark hair, her baby in her arms, looking scared. But the look in her eyes as she wipes away the tears is no different from the way my mother has cared for me over the years. She uses words that sound exotic and strange, like silk or spices or soft summer rain. You don't put your baby on a boat that might sink, or through metal wire that stings. You don't run from your family home, where you have seen your loved ones grow. You don't leave behind the memories made, unless those places make you feel afraid. As I sit here, my mother by my side, on the news watching the sea bring in the tide, I watch the water wash up those short-lived lives, and the screaming mothers laying by their side. A mother's love is stronger than any other bond. I wish to share in that love. Stop the heartache and stop dropping bombs.
Congratulations.
Take a picture as well.
Well, EDL, police ain't playing out yet. They ganged up, they want to rush man, grab man, talking about, what are you doing in town? Walking is town. Yeah. Although we ain't doing anything wrong, we're just minding our business. The anti side looked like it had a bigger crowd than the actual EDL side. How was we wrong? There's a bag of them, so head that way, you'll see. But be careful, because the police ain't playing.
Nah.
Yeah, if you're the wrong colour, you're getting snatched.
Yo, so Coventry representing the Muslim Brothers, yeah? How you feeling about this whole EDL situation, really?
It's just pointless, isn't it, really? EDL coming around, taking like 2 grams of base, thinking they're bad. I'll come here just to see. Never been to one of these things, but you know.
So how do you feel about when them, they were up there earlier saying things like, fucking, they're done with, they're tired of Islam and all kind of things.
I'm not down with no extremists, yeah? Even if it's one of the Muslim people and they're extremists, it's like, listen, love music, hate racism.
Straight.
So why have you got 5 men to round the room for? I said, that's the pressure. Yeah? I said, if we get you round there, 5 men now, what is it? You can be on the radio. Oh, blah, 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 this, that. I said, so what are you doing? Move away from him. He's like, the sergeant tried to talk. I let him speak. I said, go and talk. I said, anyway, as I was saying, I just blanked him. The inspector's big ass geezer, bro. He's bigger than my man. Big as hell, breathing on this guy. I said, what in the hell? I said, this is kind of like a bit weird. Yeah. I said, do you think we're going to walk into the path of these people? I said, the man wants to get a better look, so he's like this. Yeah, I had my camera out. I said, the same I did when I was around the anti side. Yeah? I said, I'm sure they're posing pictures. You don't know what I do. He said, oh, yeah, true. He shut his mouth. He took time, they all disappear. They all just walked up.
Off our streets! Nazi scum! Off our streets! There you go.
EDL's finest.
EDL's finest.
What were they doing?
Jumping in front of us, trying to cause a riot.
Yeah.
After that, so hold on, basically, they're inciting problems.
Yeah, I know.
They're trying to aggravate people, so people will fight with them.
Trying to get nicked.
And then they get
nicked.
I don't know.